Good to see you again. In this screencast, we're going to explore two functionalities of the block editor that prove to be very useful if you use them together: grouping and reusing blocks. I will start by explaining why and when these options are so very useful, and of course, I will also show you how it works in practice. Because that's why you're watching this screencast, right? Let's take a look at the button in our post. There it is. It would be very well possible that I want to use this button in various future posts. Wouldn't it be nice if I can use the same button everywhere instead of creating a new one over and over again? Luckily, in the block editor, you can use the reusable blocks option to save a block when you want to reuse it. This is how it works. I select the block and make sure that you see these blue lines if you select a button block. Then I click on the three vertical dots at the end of the toolbar and select the Add to Reusable Blocks option from the drop-down menu. This opens up an input field above the block, which allows me to give the block a name. Let's name it Yoast Apply Button and click Save. Good. Now, where can I find this block when I want to reuse it? Well, it's hard to miss it, as the reusable blocks have their own tab. Let's add a new block, click the reusable tab, and there it is. There's even a preview of it when you hover over it. Super convenient. You can also find your reusable blocks by typing in reusable over here. Or, if you know the name of your block, by typing that name. Now, this button is just one relatively simple block. But what if I wanted to reuse not only this button, but also this heading, this paragraph, and this list in future posts? Should I save all blocks as reusable blocks separately? Or is there a more efficient way to reuse this complete section? Yes, there is a more efficient way. You can group them. If you want to create a group block from scratch, you just add a new block. Scroll down to Design, and there you will find the group block. Now you can select which block you want to add first in your group block. For example, a heading. And if you press Enter, you can add a new block, which is also in this group block. So I will add a paragraph, etc. You get the idea. Now these blocks are connected, and they stay connected, even if you click somewhere else. Remember that we selected blocks to move them all at once in the previous video? This is not the same. These blocks are now really connected into a group block. Blocks in blocks, so to speak. However, the moving part works the same. You can move group blocks up and down, and all the nested blocks move along. Just make sure that you select the group block. You can do that by selecting one of the elements in the group. Now hover over the transformation button, and hey, this group icon will appear out of the blue. Click it to select the group block. Now you can use the arrows to move the block up or down. But there's more than one way to go about this. You can also use the block navigation in the top toolbar or click Group over here. Now, this is how you create a group block from scratch. But what if you have already created a post with individual blocks and then decide that you want to group some of them? Can you do that? Yes, you can. Let's get rid of this group block first and then go back to the four individual blocks I've created earlier. Before we start grouping these blocks, I'll have to convert the reusable button block into a regular block, because otherwise things are going to get messy. So I select the block, click the dots, and convert to regular block. Okay, back to business. Let's select them all and transform the selection, you know how that works, into a group block. Now you can see that this heading is part of a group. You can also ungroup by clicking the three dots and then ungroup. Let's group them again by selecting all blocks and then clicking the three dots. Now you can choose group. You can even use drag and drop to create a group. But in my opinion, these two options are faster and easier. By the way, if you want to move or edit one element of your group block, just click that block and do whatever you wish to do. However, this all started with a question about reusing blocks. The question was, should I save all blocks as reusable blocks separately, or is there a more efficient way to reuse this complete section? The answer is yes, You can reuse a complete section by grouping blocks and then save the group block as a reusable block. Let's do that. Add to reusable blocks. Then give it a name, like Apply for Yoast Diversity Fund. Save. Awesome. In a way, it's like creating a small template that you can reuse for every new post. Okay. Is there anything else you need to know? Yes, there is one last yet essential thing you need to know about reusable blocks, and that has to do with editing. Editing a reusable block in one place will change this block everywhere. Let me show you what I mean. Here, let's create a test post with the reusable button block I've just made. Check out what happens when I try to edit the reusable block here. I will click Edit, and then I change the text of the button. Click Save. Now I go back to our Diversity Fund post. And look what happened. The text of the button changed here as well. Even if I had already published this post and then added the reusable block in another post, the block would still change everywhere. In addition, the reusable block you can find in the blocks list is also edited according to the latest version. So better keep this in mind if you want to avoid any unwanted surprises. What if you don't want the block to change in all posts? Sometimes you just want to make a small edit for one specific post. If that's what you want, then you should convert your reusable block into a regular block before you edit it. So I select the reusable block, click on the three dots in the toolbar, and select Convert to Regular Block. Once it is regular, you can make your changes. Now the changes will only apply to this block. One last thing before we wrap this up. You can manage all your reusable blocks in one place. Click the Reusable tab and then click this link here. In this overview, you can edit or delete your blocks. And you can export them. If you have more than one WordPress site, you can use your reusable blocks there as well. Simply import your export file by clicking this button. You can now use your reusable block on your other site as well. Really cool, right?